Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find sum of elements in array. So here I have an array which contains five elements, five different type of elements. And every element can be located by using index number. There's a AF 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So totally I have a five elements. So because index will start from 0, so the maximum index will be the 4. So that means n minus 1. So now we need to find out sum of these elements. So to find out the sum of elements, we need to extract each and every element from this array and add all these elements into some variable. So we need to perform addition operator between addition operation between each and every element. All right. So let's see how we can do this programmatically. Now let me just go and open my Eclipse. And here, let's go to our project. I'll create a new Java class. And I will name it as sum of array. And let's take a main method and then click on the finish. So here I will just first create one array which contains a different elements. Let's say integer, and we need to give some name of the array. Let's say A is a name of the array and bracket equal to, and we need to also specify the size of an array, and we can add the values, or we can directly add values into this array by using curly braces. Let me just put some values here. Let's say 5, 2, let's say 7, 9, and 6. So now I have added a few values into this particular array. So basically this is a single dimensional array. Now this A is an array which contains a five different elements. Now I will take one more variable. Let's say sum. I'll make it as a 0 initially. Now I'll write a loop statement, and which will repeat multiple times, depends on number of values, and each iteration I will extract a value from this array and I will add that value to the sum. Now here I'll create one loop statement, and here I need to start from the 0 because these values will be located by using index number. So here I'll take a variable called I, which is representing index, start from 0. Now, how many values we have here? Five values we have. So we can specify like I less than 5. So here we can put condition like this. For example, we are starting from the 0 index. The last index will be the 4 because these are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 is the last index. Suppose here the number of elements are 5. So if I say n is equal to number of elements, so the last index always will be n minus 1. So that is equal to 4. So once you're writing your loop statement here, we are starting from 0 index. So when we need to stop here is, as soon as I value becomes 4, we need to stop there. So we can write condition like I is equal to 4, I equal to 4, so that even 4 is also matched. As soon as I value become 5, then condition become false. So there are no more elements. Or you can also write I less than 5. So when I say I less than 5, so 4 will be 4 is less than 5, till 4 it is matching, but as soon as I value become 5, 5 less than 5 will not match, so the condition become false. So what I can do is I can say I less than or equal to, I'll say 4. Suppose sometimes if you don't know how many elements are there inside this array, still you want to find how many elements are there, like the length of array we need to find. So instead of outputting this value, what I can say is we'll say a dot length. So a dot length, length is a keyword which will give you the size of an array. So that means it will give you how many number of values we have inside this array. So it will return 5. So after that we can make it minus 1. So a dot length will give you 5. 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. So how many times this loop will repeat? 5 times it will repeat, so that we are starting index from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, and also 4 also match. But as soon as it become 5, it will not match. So because I say a dot length minus 1 will be returned 4. So you can just notice here, a dot length will return 5. So a dot length minus 1 means it is 4. Okay. So after that, let me also increment this index plus plus. So now inside the for loop, what I have to do is we need to extract each and every element from this array. So how to extract each and every element? Let us say array name of index number. So A of 1. So currently I value 0. So it is representing A of 0. So what's the value we have in the A of 0? 5 is there. So that value we need to add to the sum. Now here I'll write expression like this. Sum is equal to sum plus A of I. Now what happens? The first time I value 0, condition is true, and it will come here. So A of 1 means it will locate 5, the first element, 0 element. So now sum is already 0, 0 plus 0, totally 0 plus A of I is 5. So 0 plus 5, sum is equal to 5. So once expression is executed, the value of sum is 5, initially 5. So after that, again it will go up, and I plus plus. So I value incremented by 1. Now 1 less than or equal to A dot length of minus 1. So A dot length minus 1 means it is exactly 4. Okay, let me directly write here. This is 4. So now currently I value becomes initial I value 0, the condition is done. Now I value becomes 1 in second iteration. Now 1 less than or equal to 4, right? So the condition is true. Now again it will come here. So currently I value is equal to 1. So A of 1. A of 1 means 2 will be retrieved. So the 2 will be added to the existing value inside the sum. So previously sum contains 5. So now the 2 will be added to the sum. Now it will become plus 2 now. Now again it will go up and get I plus plus, index is increased. Now again condition is true. So now I value becomes 2 here. Then condition again true. So it will capture the next value from this array. The 0 element is done. First element is also done. Now we are retrieving the next element, that is 7. So now A of I means A of 2, which is representing 7. Now 7 will be added to the existing value. Now 7 is added. Now again go up, I plus plus. So that means I value becomes 3 now. So again 3 less than or equal to A dot length minus 1, condition is true. So again it will come here. So A dot 3 means we will get 9 as an element. So already in the sum we have few values. Now the new value will be added, that is 9. Now go up, next round. And this is the last iteration. Now I value become 4. So 4 less than or equal to A dot length minus 1. So A dot length minus 1 is 4. I value is also 4. 4 less than or equal to 4, condition is true. Now here A of I means A of 4. Now fourth element will be retrieved, that is 6. Now 6 will be added to the existing sum. So now it is 6 is added, right? So 5 plus 2 plus 7 plus 9 plus 6. So the total value will be stored inside the sum variable. Now after that, I value becomes 5. As soon as I value becomes 5, so then condition become false. Then it will exit from the looping statement. Now after coming out from this loop statement, I will print sum. Let's say system.out.println sum of array elements, and here I will print sum here, right? So that's it, right? So this is how we need to perform sum of elements from array. Let's execute this, run as Java application. Now it is giving exactly 29 that we are expecting. So 5 plus 2 7, 7 plus 7 14, 14 plus 9 23, 23 plus 9 6 29. So exactly it is written 29 as an output, right? So similarly we can also change these elements and we can find the sum of elements, right? So this is how we can retrieve each and every element from this array based on index, by using an index, and check the condition. How many times we need to repeat this loop depends on the number of elements. So how we will know number of elements? By using a length keyword, we can get number of elements. Okay, so this is one approach. By using for loop, we can retrieve the data, each and every element, and we can add that value to the sum variable. So finally, we will get the sum of values from array. The same thing we can also do by using enhanced for loop. So there is another kind of for loop we have in Java. So using that for loop also, we can do that. So what is the advantage of using enhanced for loop? Let me just write it here. Enhanced for loops. So what is an advantage of enhanced for loop? So when I use enhanced for loop, especially for arrays, I no need to specify any initialization, condition, and incrementation. So that's an advantage of using enhanced for loop. Now I will show you how to read each and every element, or how we can find sum of elements by using enhanced for loop. Let me just comment the first approach. right? So now I'm going to show you the next approach. So enhancer for now, again, have an array which contains some elements and sum is equal to zero initial value. Now here, let me write enhanced for loop. Let's say for, and this is syntax. Here we don't have any initialization, condition and incrementation. So everything is taken care by enhanced for loop. Now here, I will specify the name of the array, colon. And here I will define a variable called integer. I can give any name, like here we are not going to use any index kind of thing. Okay, so that's another advantage. We don't need to use any index to retrieve the data from the array. So I can just give some variable called value, right? So inside this, I will write one expression, sum is equal to sum plus value. Simple, that's it. So now we'll see how we can execute this loop. So how exactly it will execute. So initially, array contains multiple values, right? So array contains a multiple value. These are the values. So how this is loop is going to execute is, from this array, A is an array, right? A contains a multiple values. So 5 is there, 2, 7, 9, and 6. So these are the current values we have in this array. So first time, first round, from this A, from this array, it will take the first element, 5, will be assigned to the value. So 5 is taken first. Now the current value is 5. Now come inside this loop. Here sum is 0 initially, 0 plus value. So what is the value here? 5. So 0 plus 5, 5. So sum is 5 here. Now again it will go up. Second round it will choose a second value. It will pick up the second value, 2. Now the second round it will assign 2 here. Now the current value of the value is 2. Now already in the sum we have a 5. So now current value is 2. 2 will be added to the sum. Now it becomes a 7. 5 plus 2, 7. After that, again, it will go up. Next round, it will get the next value, which is 7. So 7 will be assigned to the same value, this time 7. Now previously already 7 is there in the sum. Now 7 plus another 7. So it becomes a 14 now. So next time it will retrieve the 9, store that into value 9. 9 will be added to the existing sum. So existing sum contains a 14 plus 9. So 14 plus 9, 23, it becomes a 23. So again, next round, the last element, which is 6. So it will get the 6. And already in the sum, we have a 23. Now the value will be 6. So for 23, it will be added 6. So totally 29. Now the sum is having 29. Again, it will go up and check, is there any elements are there or not? So there are no elements found. Then it loop will be exited. So this is how this enhanced for loop works. So this is also called as a for each loop. So it will automatically repeat multiple times, depends on the number of values. That's the one advantage of using enhanced for loop. And here we no need to specify any condition, any incrementation. So it will automatically increment to the next increment will be happen every time for every iteration and capture the new values. So when it will stop, as soon as it reached end of this array, and it finds no more elements, then it will exit from this loop. So that's how we need to use enhanced for loop to read the data from array and also have done sum of elements, right? Now let us execute and see how it is going to work. So let me run as Java application. So now we got the same value, which is 29. Okay, so this is how we can find sum of elements in array by using a normal for loop, where we need to specify the index to retrieve the value from array. The other approach is we can use enhanced for loop, and here we haven't used any index number. Okay, so that's all for this video, guys. So we have seen how to find sum of array elements. All right, so thanks for watching this video.